Okay, semua dah hand in ke? Okay, turn in. Don't worry kalau dah tak dapat kosong pun. No worries. Alright. Okay, today kita akan masuk semester baru. Okay. New semester, we will learn chapter 3 and chapter 5. Okay. Ada tak dapat 6 and above? Anyone? Ada tak? Okay, tak apa, nanti cikgu review balik jawapan. Okay, kita akan masuk chapter 3. Okay, buka buku teks page 42. Okay, today kita akan learn 3.1 relative atomic mass and relative molecular mass. Okay, open textbook 4.2, 42. Okay, kalau semua kita tengok dekat sini, okay. This is sate. So, apa yang kita guna untuk bakar sate? Tajuk ni tak masuk. It's 1, 2 and 4. Okay, apa kita guna untuk bakar sate? Topic 3. Fire, made of course. Of course. Arang. Okay, kita guna arang. Arang is adalah carbon. Okay, kalau kita tengok dekat this chemical equation ni. Ni adalah chemical equation representing the combustion of carbon. Okay, apa yang akan jadi? Carbon akan react with oxygen. Okay, and then it will produce CO2, carbon dioxide. Okay, nanti kita, this topic kita akan deal how to write the chemical equation. How do we calculate the amount of element lah. Okay, kita ada product and reactant. The amount of reactant needed to produce the product. Okay. Kita masuk dulu 3.1. Okay, kita akan belajar relative atomic mass. Okay. Do you still remember dalam our periodic table, okay, kita ada proton number. Ada apa lagi? Satu lagi. We have proton number and proton number. Is it? Siapa ke tulis? Kita ada proton and apa satu lagi in the periodic table? No, elektron tak ada, nucleon number. Okay, the nucleon number adalah the relative atomic mass. It is the same but different, depends on the context. Okay, for nucleon, dia adalah jumlah proton and neutron. Okay, but for relative atomic mass, dia adalah berat atom tersebut. Okay, kalau kita dengar perkataan relative, it means kita comparekan dengan something yang lain. Okay, macam hari is relative. Okay, hari ini hari Selasa. Hari Selasa adalah hari yang ketiga dalam minggu kalau Kedah lah, kan. Tapi kalau untuk minggu yang start bekerja hari Isnin, ialah hari kedua bekerja. So, it is relative. Depends on yang mana kita comparekan. Therefore, untuk relative atomic mass ni, berat dia kita comparekan dengan carbon, 12. Okay, kenapa carbon 12? Before this, okay, kita ada multiple scientists. Ada dalam multiple camps, ada yang kata I want to use oxygen, I want to compare the mass of element to oxygen, I want to compare with hydrogen, ada yang nak compare dengan helium. Okay, and then in 1961 dia orang pergi mesyuarat and then dia choose to use carbon 12 as a standard. Okay, semua ingat kita ada SI unit. Okay, SI unit tu semua dah setuju, semua orang akan guna benda tu. Cikgu dah jumpa dah. Alright. And then they use carbon. Sebab apa dia guna carbon? Okay. Carbon kalau kita tahu, dia ada 6 proton and then 6 neutron. Okay. Dia adalah one of the element yang special in the periodic table that have the same number of proton and then the same number of neutron. Mostly neutron akan difference from the proton number. Therefore, this is one of the example carbon 12 is used. And then another thing is carbon 12 ni relatively abundant. Maksudnya banyak isotope dia stable and dia banyak dekat dalam apa kita punya natural ni. Kita punya muka bumi. Alright. So, macam mana kita nak kira relative atomic mass of element? Okay, macam mana dia kira? Kalau kita tengok dekat jadual ni, okay, kena tahu, this ni kena tahu definition, the relative atomic mass. Okay. Define as the average mass of an atom of the element compared to 1 over 12 of the mass of one carbon 12 atom. Sebab apa 1 over 12? Because the mass of one carbon 12 atoms adalah 12. Okay. So 1 over 12 times 12, kita akan dapat 1 lah. Okay. So kita akan dapat, katalah for example sodium, 23. 23 divide by 1, kita akan dapat the relative atomic mass adalah 23. Dia tak ada unit, okay, sebab dia adalah relative. Macam hari kan, hari tak ada unit, okay, 2 hari, 3 hari, macam tu. Tapi untuk sama juga nuclear number, dia punya unit pun tak ada juga, proton and neutron lah, same as relative atomic mass. Okay. Jap. Okay, so kena tahu baca the periodic table. Okay, the periodic table, the proton number akan sama dengan electron number. Okay, and then the nuclear number akan sama dengan the relative atomic mass. Jap. Okay, kita pergi ke soalan pretest tadi. Okay, number 4. Kita akan belajar masuk ke relative molecular mass. Okay, tak, cikgu pergi dulu soalan 1. Determine the type of particles in the carbon C. Okay, apa jawapan dia? Apa rasa, apa jawapan dia? Type of particle, atoms, electrons, ion, type of particle. Atom, okay, akan ada atom. Number 2, type of particles in oxygen. Apa pula? O2 tu bukan O. It should be molecules, okay, molecules. Bukan atom, molecule. Okay, molecule ni apabila two atom of the same element combine. Macam O2, H2, Cl2, they are molecule. Okay, number 3, it is compound tapi kita panggil dia sebagai ionic compound. Okay, compound ni terjadi bila two different elements, okay, combine. Macam tadi molecule, two elements yang apa tu atoms of the same element combine, but for compounds more than two lah, okay, two and above atoms of the different element combine, so dia akan jadi compound. Tapi ni adalah ionic compound. Nanti kita akan pergi later lah untuk chapter 5. Okay, number 4, siapa boleh jawab ni? Calculate the relative molecular mass of hydrogen, H2. Siapa boleh jawab? Okay, check dalam periodic table, page 2, 135. Okay, page what 276 or 275. Check. Apa relative molecular mass of hydrogen? Kita akan tengok. Relative bukan molecular, atomic. Should be satu. Okay. Tapi for molecular, bila dia dah combine tu, okay, kita darab. Okay, kita darab. Kita tengok dulu macam mana. Kita ada dua ketul. Okay. Dekat sini, okay. Relative molecular mass. Macam mana nak kira? Sekejap, cikgu share jambot. Oops. Okay, semua nampak. Okay, kita pergi ke jambot. Soalan tadi dia cakap calculate the molecular mass of H2. Tadi H2. Okay. Selalunya in questions dia akan provide the relative atomic mass. Tadi dalam questions kat sini dia tulis relative atomic mass H, which is 1. Okay, 1. Okay, kita tahu RM dia, RM for H adalah 1. So, how do we calculate relative molecular? Okay, remember molecular. Kita nak calculate RMM. Okay, H2. Jadi macam mana? Kita tengok dekat sini. Kita ada dua ketul of H. Therefore, kita ambil dua tu darab dengan relative atomic mass. So, kita akan dapat 2. Okay, kita akan dapat 2. This is for molecular. Okay, kita pergi tengok pula contoh yang lain. Okay, that in this textbooks, okay, dia cakap for oxygen, oxygen gas is a molecule. So, O2. Therefore, kita ambil 2 sebab ada 2 ketul times RM of O, which is 16. 2 times 16, kita dapat 32. Okay, tu kalau kita calculate molecular mass untuk one molecule. So, macam mana kalau untuk water? Okay, kalau water kita tahu formula dia ialah H2O. Okay, RM untuk H adalah 1 dan untuk oksigen is 16. So macam mana kita nak calculate RRMM untuk H2O? Kita ambil 2 dulu, okay, kita times by 1 for the hydrogen. Okay, lepas tu kita tambah, okay, dia tak boleh darab. Kita tambah dengan yang oksigen pula, which is seketul darab 1 darab dengan 16. So, kita akan dapat 18. Yes, this is the basic behind chemistry, maths. Okay, next. Tapi don't worry. Okay, chemistry tak involve differentiation. Okay. Okay, oh yes. Oh, dia punya RM adalah 16. Okay, it involve basics maths lah. Okay. Plus darab, tambah, tolak, bahagi. Sekejap mana dia. Alright. Okay, this is for RMM. Tetapi untuk ionic compound, same juga formula dia. Calculation macam cikgu tunjuk tadi. But the name je yang berbeza. Which is, kita panggil formula mass, RFM. So, kalau untuk molekul, RMM. Dan untuk ionic, kita guna RFM. Tapi cara kiraan still sama. Okay, contohnya cikgu tunjuk yang zinc chloride ni. Okay, zinc chloride. Okay. Formula for zinc chloride adalah ZnCl2. RAM untuk zinc ialah berapa dia bagi? 65. Okay, RAM untuk zinc 65. And then RAM untuk Cl adalah 35.5. Jadi, macam mana kita nak kira? Dia tulis dulu RFM, remember since this ionic compound. Macam mana nak tahu ionic compound? Okay. Easiest way, depan ni ialah metal. Always metal. And then belakang di pula, sebelah kanan, akan jadi non-metal. Mesti non-metal. So, ionic compound adalah bila metal and non-metal bergabung. Okay? Okay, for RFM untuk zinc chloride, kita ada seketul saja zinc ni. So, apa yang kita buat? 1 darab 65 plus, remember plus. Bila kita pergi ke another element, kita plus. Okay, Cl2. Kita ada dua ketul Cl and then 35.5. So kita akan dapatlah berapa? 342. 3136. RFM is a relative formula mass. It, the calculation is the same as relative molecular mass, but the name dia. Name is different because it is for ionic compound. Okay, formula ni for ionic compound. Okay, kita akan buat activity. Okay, semua pergi ke classroom. Klik dekat activity for 3.1. Okay, just write your answer. A, B, C, D. Okay, do question 1 until 5. Okay, I give you 5 minutes. Based on ni lah, predict table from the nucleon number. Tapi in exam, dia akan bagi tahu dekat questions tu. Okay, it means there are 6 molecule of CN. It tak boleh jadi C6N6. It should be CN and in bracket and then another 6. Okay, kalau yang slow tu, tengok je screen ni. Okay? And then just write A, B, C, D. Yes, there are 4K, 1 FE and 6 CN. Okay, remember for when we go to apa? New element, we just add, okay? Kalau 4K tu, we have 4 pieces of K, we times 4. It takes the RAM and times by 4. Because I teach the fundamentals, so this is the application. Buat soalan ni, dekat skrin ni. Jawab A, B, C, D. 1, 2, 5. Dua-dua ada enam. CN tu ada enam. Okay. Ambil C campur dengan N times by 6. Okay, for CN, we cannot call it as atomic mass. It is molecular mass. Okay, we take atomic mass of C and then plus with the atomic mass of N. Okay, 1 minute. One minute left. Okay, time's up. Okay. Dekat klik, okay. Cikgu show the calculation for question 1. Okay, the chemical formula for potassium hexanoferrate. Okay, kita ada K4 Fe Pn and then 6. So apa yang kita boleh buat? 4 times K, berapa K? Kita tak perlu hafal sebab dia dah bagi. Okay. 39. Okay, 39. Plus, okay, Fe. Okay, kita 1 sebab ada seketul dia. Fe 56. Oh. 56. Okay, kemudian kita ambil C which is 12 and N which is 14. Okay. B is 12, 14. Kita akan dapat 26. 6 times 26. Okay, berapa? Tengokkan. Yes, 39 times 5, 39 times 6. Yes, should be. Jawapan dia adalah 368D. Okay, for number 2, relative atomic mass of an element is the number of times apa yang mana? Dia tahu dia use carbon tu eh. So A tu dah salah. Okay, A dah salah. So, B, C ataupun D. Atomic mass. So B tu kira salah because it's molecule. So either B ataupun C. So we use B ataupun C. Remember it's 1 over 12. Okay, or carbon atom. Choose. So it should be C. The answer for number 2 is C. Okay, number 3. Mass of 2 element Y equals, okay, ni cikgu tunjuk lah. Okay, mass of element 2 atoms of Y, okay, 2Y is equal to 3 oxygen. Okay, 3 oxygen. Kita tahu oxygen is 16. So, dia bukan 30, 3O. So, 3 times 16 Y bagi 2. So, apa? Number 3 is B. Okay. Number 4. Sama juga. Ni macam sama soalan 3 tadi. How many atoms of nitrogen has the same mass of one atom of iron? Okay. Nitrogen is 14. And then Fe is 56. So apa yang kita boleh buat? 56 bahagi dengan 14. Kita nampak 4. Okay, number 4 is C. 4. Okay, 5. Relative molecular masses can be calculated by apa dia? The relative to make mass. Yes, tapi bukan solely. Okay, bukan dia punya saja. Okay. Sebab molecule, molecular mass. So, jawapan dia adalah B. Adding up the relative atomic mass. Ataupun multiply. Mana satu? B ke D? Number 5. Number 5 is B. Okay, adding up. For number 4 is C. Okay, number 5 adalah B, adding up the relative atomic mass. Sebab molekular, okay, molekular macam oksigen tadi tu, kita just darab, okay, tambah je, bukan darab. Kita darab, we add, kita sorry, kita multiply with the berapa ketul yang ada, which is yang depan tu adalah number of moles sepatutnya. Okay, don't worry about that, nanti kita akan masuk next class. Okay. Dah ada satu, cikgu ada satu lagi aktiviti. Okay, nanti answer tu just submit terus dekat template cikgu dah buat ni. Okay, this is homework sebab kita ada masa lagi boleh buat sekarang. Okay, open textbook page 49. Okay, test yourself 3.1. Answer all questions. Okay, write your answers only. Tapi for questions 2 and 3, show your calculations. If page 49. Cikgu dah buat template tu, just write je dekat situ. Okay, ni questions dia. Siapa yang tak nampak boleh klik kat sini dulu. Tengok dekat screen. Okay. Tulis atas kertas, terus tulis. Okay, nanti upload je. Okay, siapa yang boleh buka Google Classroom tu boleh tulis dekat template yang cikgu buat tu. Okay, number one tu adalah dia punya maksud. So, kena tepat lah. Okay, apa dia? Dia nak maksud, okay? Boleh buka page 44. Dia dah tulis dah maksud dia. Edina tak ada ke? Siapa tahu Edina ada masuk kelas ke tak? Kelas yang lain-lain. Okay, esok, test akan ada esok, 5 o'clock, okay, in the evening. Okay, so make sure test your internet connection during co-curriculum, okay. Kalau ada problem, tak boleh load Google Form semua tu, bagi tahu cikgu atau telefon cikgu, okay. Nanti cikgu bagikan tadi jawab je atas kertas. And then tempoh masa untuk jawab, okay, sejam cikgu bagi. Cikgu buka open, okay, from 5 until 6. Okay, 6 and above cikgu tutup terus dia punya apa tu response. Okay, akan ada 3 section. Section 1, section A, objective, 10 questions. Section B, 2 questions, subjective. And then section C, ada sikit. Macam essay but not essay lah. Okay, kena draw table. 10 marks. 1 question, 10 marks. So, total 30 marks. Okay. Yes, test is tomorrow. Okay, and then on Thursday, okay, dalam no, tak masuk RAM ni, tak masuk chapter 1, 2 and 4. Okay, but kena ingat yang tak ada dalam buku teks pun ada juga, which is the electronic configuration tu. Okay, quantum number, okay, akan naik. And then for Thursday, our class in the morning, kalau based on jadual, okay. But I have some things to do in the morning. So, kelas petang, okay. Waktu sejarah. Macam ni juga. 3:15 until 4:15. Okay, kalau dah siap ni, okay. Tak ada homework hari ni, okay. Homework ni sepatutnya due date on 3 suku lah hari Thursday tu. Okay, lengkap kan ni? Senang je. Number 2 ni sama macam soalan yang number 4 tadi tu. Table, macam kalau tak table macam mana nak tulis? Tulis atas lantai. It's the open book test, boleh buka buku teks. Okay, periodic table pun boleh check. Yes, no Google. can use Internet Explorer. Bing. Yes, boleh buka Google Text. Okay, kalau soalan question, okay, macam exam kan. Kadang nak prepare the table tu needs another muka surat. So, dalam questions tu akan bagi. Akan bagi the RIM, the molecular mass. Molecular mass tak bagilah. Tu kita kena calculate. Dia akan bagi RIM. Okay. Silver in the table. Silver is Ag. The symbol is Ag. Okay, it is in group 11. Okay. How to calculate RMM? Okay. Find the RAM from the RAM. Okay. For example, CH4 ni. Okay. Yes. Add up the RAM. Tapi you have to multiply with the number of atoms yang hasing. For example, untuk methane ni. Okay. We take RAM of C, which is 12. Okay. 12. Times by 1. Okay, kenapa times by 1? Sebab C ni ada 1. We have only 1 C. And then we plus tambah 4 times RAM of H, which is 1. Okay. NaCl, we need 2 times by 2. No, you don't need 2 times by 2. NaCl, 1 times RAM of Na plus 1 times C, times RAM of Cl. Yes, macam Alan tulis. Nitrogen Na in the table. Nitrogen is N, 14. Na is not nitrogen, okay? Na is Avogadro constant. And to chapter 3.2. So we are going to learn later on Thursday. We have 118 elements. Yes, C plus H times by 4. Okay, siapa yang dah siap boleh show your answer. Okay, share screen. Question 1 is just a definition, okay? So, copy lah, okay? Copy the definition. Mostly kalau exam is 1 marks, okay? So, kalau nak tahu definition, you have to know the key points lah dalam tu. For example, untuk relative atomic mass ni, kalau kita pergi dekat dalam buku teks, page 44. Okay, this. So, the keywords adalah every mass of an atom. Okay. Compared to 1 over 12 mass of 1 carbon 12 atom. 1 marks. Okay, when we bring textbook to test, in real life tak boleh lah, okay? But for tomorrow test boleh lah. Oh, tomorrow is open book test, so it'll be slightly harder. Okay, cikgu pergi questions 2A ni. Okay, how many lithiums, atoms of lithium are required to equalize mass of one atom of krypton? So macam mana? You have to show your work, okay? Calculations, kena tunjuk. Tak boleh terus congak. Boleh lah congak, okay? Kena tunjuk dia apa, jalan kira. Okay, take the mass of krypton, okay, which is 84. Let's check. 84, okay, and then divide by 7 lithium tu. So untuk 4, untuk satu krypton, we need 12 lithiums, okay. Tak, yes, 12. Okay, untuk B, how many atoms of helium are required to equalize the mass of one silver atom? Kita pergi AG 108. Okay, mass of helium adalah 4. Bukan 2, 4. And then 27, we get 27. What I got, the number of elements should be 118. Don't forget, calculate yang dekat bawah tu. 118, yang mana? Lori 1, yang mana? For 2B or 2A? So 84 divide 42A, the mass of krypton is 84, but the mass of lithium is 7. Okay, 84 divide by 7, kita akan dapat 12. So we need 12 atoms of lithium to have the same we have the same mass as one atom of krypton. Okay, and then for B, kita tanya, how many helium atom ni to have the same mass of one atom of silver? So we take the mass of silver, which is 108, okay, and then we divide with 4. Sebab mass of helium adalah 4, the RM. Okay, so kita akan dapat 27. Okay, ada siapa-siapa nak try soalan 3, A, B, C dan D? Kita ada lagi 4 minit. Okay, siapa nak try? A tu cikgu dah bagi clue tadi. Okay, kita buat B, C dan D. B, C dan D. Is there a way to find elements easier? Macam mana? What do you mean by easier? Wait, my computer hang. Oh.